Where the hell have you been, soldier?
Training, sir!
Training, sir!
What kind of training, son?
Army training, sir!
Army training, sir!
Army basic training, right? I went to basic training in Fort Jackson, South Carolina, and we got there late at night. So there was no drill sergeant welcome, none of that stuff, right? We just got there, they put us in formation, and we started reception. Most of you have seen in movies, or they're on a bus. As soon as they get there, the drill sergeants come up into the bus, they start yelling, they get in their face. It's a really unpleasant time. What reception is, it's where you go and pretty much it's like you're in processing. You get your uniforms, you go get checked out medically, you get your hair cut. And when you first get to reception, they give you this little credit card. I think it has like $250 on it. And you have to pay for certain things like your haircut. I knew that you would get your haircut in basic training. Well, I've had this hairstyle ever since 7th grade. They sit me down on the chair and they're like, oh, well, you really don't need your haircut, do you? I'm like, nope. And he's like, well, I'm going to cut it anyways. So he takes that little credit card and he charges me just to run the clipper over my head twice and say, ah, well, it's not cutting anything, bye. I thought that was kind of messed up. When we got to our basic training company, they split us up into our platoons. 4 platoons for the company. And the platoon areas are underneath the bays that you sleep in. It's to give you shade. That's where your platoons line up for PT. 3rd platoon, the platoon I was put into, for the primary drill sergeant, was Drill Sergeant Blunt. He kind of reminded me of Lou Gossett Jr. in An Officer and a Gentleman, I think the movie is. And our secondary platoon sergeant was Drill Sergeant Rios. After they did their introduction, they picked out the platoon guide and the squad leaders. Well, they picked me for first squad leader. I don't know why. And Drill Sergeant Blunt picked this little female to be the platoon guide. He went on to call her Soldier Punctual, and that was because she always had the platoon in the right area, in formation at the right time, with the right equipment that they needed. So our morning routine every morning was to wake up, get total line in the bay, and start reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. And I can't tell you how many times I saw guys that were so tired that they would total line and they would completely fall over. And that was a mistake because the line that we're standing on is the border between where you can walk and what's called the kill zone. A lot of bays have a platoon art that's done and they don't want you walking on it. Now when we were going through reception and we got our uniforms, one of the uniforms we got was the PT uniform. Before 9/11, we had the old gray PTs, gray top, gray bottom. And when we got these PTs, they told us, hey, look inside, there's a liner in there. So they told us not to wear underwear because we had the liner in the PT shorts. Okay, so here's the funny part about the PT uniforms, right? So every morning after you wake up and you toe the line, you're already wearing your PT uniform because you wear it to bed. You go to your walk locker and you get your canteen and you get your PT mat. Then you run downstairs and get information to start PT for the day. And after we get information, the platoon guide, Soldier Punctual, she would put us at attention. And we were standing at attention vertically and horizontally. And all the females in basic training got a good look at everyone's phallic package. Then you got grenade training. Now when we go to the live grenade range, again we ruck march out there. Before that we get ready, we put on all of our camo. I got a shaving profile and I was allowed to grow out my hair to 1/4 inch. And then I had to trim it or shave it off. One thing I kept longer than 1/4 inch was my mustache. Well, when you put all that camo on, it got caked in my mustache. Under my load-bearing equipment suspenders that we had back then, I folded up a washcloth. Well, I didn't know, but a little part of it was coming out the side. The drill sergeant saw that, and he's like, you're out of uniform. What are you doing? I apologize. I'm like, I'm sorry, drill sergeant. He's like, okay. He goes to walk away, and by a second step, he stops. He turns around, he comes right up to me, and he knifes me in the face, right at my mustache. And he's like, do you have a mustache? Because you're not allowed to have any facial hair, basic. And I said, no, drill sergeant, I have a shaving profile. He's like, well, that's a lot longer than your shaving profile allows. He's like, oh, so you think you can do what you want? And if it's not bad enough that a drill sergeant's yelling at me right in my face, he calls over the first sergeant of the company. And, you know, being a private in basic training, you hear first sergeant, you're like, oh, God, my life is over. First Sergeant comes up. He's like, what do we got, Drill Sergeant? He's like, look at this. We got a guy. He thinks he can grow a mustache. First Sergeant gets in my face, yells at me. Then he tells the Drill Sergeant to handle it. And he walks off. Drill Sergeant looks at me. He's like, hey, we're in the middle of this grenade stuff. So when we get back to the company area, you come see me. So after we go through our grenades.
When I give the command to execute, I want you to drop the pin, throw the grenade.
Yes, Drill Sergeant.
Drop the pin, throw the grenade.
Yes, Drill Sergeant.
Execute. Move it!
We rucked back to the company area, and we were told to go up, wash all of our camo off. So I go up, and as I'm washing the camo off my face, I buzz my mustache down to a quarter of an inch, so I wouldn't get in trouble. So I go down to the CQ area, he comes out, he looks at it, he's like, you went up there, you shaved, didn't you? I'm like, no, Drill Sergeant, there's still hair there, I didn't shave. Well, you trimmed it, I'm like, no, Drill Sergeant. The reason why it looked so long is because there was that caked-in camouflage. That's why it looked like it was longer than it was. And he looked at me, thought about it, and he bought it, and he said, watch it next time. Roger. Our first overnight experience of basic training is called a bivouac, right? And we're marching out in the woods, and we get to the bivouac area for our company. Drill Sergeant Rios, he starts telling each battle buddy group where they're going to set up their tent. And the reason why you had a battle buddy is when you were issued your shelter halves, you only got half of a tent. You got a shelter half, you got half the poles, and half the stakes. So then your battle buddy had the other half. You put them together, and then you both sleep inside that shelter half. And believe me, it's only big enough to fit two people. Well, Drill Sergeant Rios was pointing to all these different areas for people to set up for the bivouac. He points to me and my battle buddy, and he looks around and he points. There's your spot. And the spot was right next to a big mound of logs, dead leaves, tree branches, you name it, right? And I'm arachnophobic, meaning I don't like spiders, and I knew that that was a spider heaven. I mean, you could see the webs. When he said that we were going to set up there, I was like, no. And he was just in disbelief that I told him no. And he asked me, he's like, why won't you set up there? And I told him, because that's spider heaven, and I don't do spiders. He laughed at me, called me a pussy. And he's Puerto Rican, he spoke Spanish, and our PG, Soldier Punctual, she's Cuban, and she also spoke Spanish. He started talking to her in Spanish, and they were laughing back and forth, saying something. I don't know what they were saying, making fun of me, probably. But then he looks at me, he's like, okay, set up over there. So we set up our tent. Now we get to BRM week, which is basic rifle marksmanship, right? Teach you how to shoot an M16. BRM week, I thought was going to be my bread and butter. But here's the thing, I had never shot a gun, a real gun, until I started basic training. My dad taught me how to shoot with BB guns and air rifles, but I never actually went out and shot a real gun. 2 days before we went out to qualify, I got sick, and they sent me to the infirmary. And the second day I was there, they told everybody in the infirmary that if you had an under 100 degree temperature, you could go back to training if you so choose. So what I did was I put that thermometer in the center of my mouth, I didn't put it on my tongue, and I got a 99.8. And they asked me, do I want to go back to training? And I said, yes, because we're qualified. So they send me back to my company area. I get my stuff. I get in the van, and they drive me out to the qualification range. And after all the qualifications came in, I didn't get top BRM. I got third overall. But the commander gave me an honorable mention, seeing as how I had checked myself out of the hospital just to go qualify. On this last road march, it was one of the longer ones. There was a female in my platoon. She started to fall out. Everybody started to pass her. And when she got to me, trying to cheer her on, like, hey, you can do it. She's like, no, I'm hurting. I'm like, why are you hurting? She's like, oh, I'm chafing. Apparently, she had ran out of her granny panties that they issue you. And she had somehow smuggled Victoria's Secret type lacy thongs. And she had them in her wall locker. Well, she didn't have any underwear to wear. So she decided to wear those. And I don't know if you know the term camel toe. But that's how she was chafing. Probably very uncomfortable. Now, at the end of basic training, you have what's called family day. Your family comes, they see how you've transformed into a U.S. Army soldier. And then after family day, you have graduation. Well, all that shit didn't happen for me. I graduated in September of 99, and that year, Hurricane Floyd came through, okay? Right at graduation time. So our graduation got canceled. The only thing that we did have was a small family day. But funny thing that did happen was because the hurricane came through, they sent all non-essential personnel home. Well, they told us that if the alarm goes off, that the bays on top grab a pillow and their blanket, and they go down to the bays below. Well, what happened was nothing short of an orgy. Practically everybody was getting freaky with somebody. It was pretty crazy. If you weren't getting freaky with somebody, you were watching someone getting freaky with somebody. And these are like people you didn't think would be able to get any, right? That shit was crazy.